Also willkommen wieder zu unserer Sendung Standort Berlin und wir haben heute ein besonderes Thema, nämlich die Umweltkonferenz in Bonn. Seit dem 5. November findet dort die 23. Weltklimakonferenz statt. Der Klimawandel ist ein Thema, das uns alle angeht. Das merken wir auch in den Sondierungsverhandlungen zur Bildung einer großen neuen Jamaika-Koalition. Heute haben wir einen besonderen Gast in der Sendung, nämlich den taiwanesischen Umweltminister Dr. Ying-Juan Lee.
Ha.
Very welcome.
Perfect, thank you.
Der von Taiwans Botschafter in Deutschland, Professor Dr. Zhi Wei-Shi, begleitet wird. Auch Ihnen ein herzliches Willkommen. Mit beiden werde ich gleich ein interessantes Gespräch führen über Taiwans Rolle beim Kampf um ein besseres Weltklima, gegen den Klimawandel um ein besseres Weltklima. Aber vorab zeige ich Ihnen einen kurzen Film, damit Sie Eindrücke aus dem heutigen Taiwan bekommen, aus einem schönen, modernen und hochentwickelten Land. Taiwan zählt zu den 20 stärksten Volkswirtschaften der Welt und ist Deutschlands fünftgrößter Handelspartner in Asien. Dennoch darf Taiwan an der diesjährigen UN-Klimakonferenz in Bonn offiziell nicht teilnehmen. Daher gleich meine erste Frage an Taiwans Umweltminister, Herrn Dr. Lee. Warum ist es für Taiwan so wichtig, bei der Weltklimakonferenz in Bonn unter der Präsidentschaft der Fidschi-Inseln mit einbezogen zu werden?
First, thank you for inviting me here. I really like to share what we are concerned with all our German friends or international friends. Fiji and many other ocean states are facing this very serious issue of rising sea level. Because the global warming, all this country might be just buried under the sea. So all these people might become homeless. And we are also ocean state. We suffer from many typhoon strikes many times a year. So we are concerned about all these climate change issues. And so if we are not included in this international efforts to combat the climate challenge, it's unfair for us. And we may not be able to share with all the new development technology in doing all this carbon reduction mitigation or adaptation technology. So it will be important for us to be included in this international COP conference so we can learn and share our knowledge or technology, and also we can help all these ocean states. For example, we share with all these friends our weather forecasting technology to use the Solomon as example. We predict, our weather experts predict the outbreak of the dengue fever quite precisely 8 weeks in advance, according to the rainfall, because rainfall would affect the amount of mosquitoes, and which will affect the epidemic of dengue fevers. For that, we can contribute. Just one example. So it would be important for the international community to have us together, jointly, to combat this climate change.
Ist es denn überhaupt möglich, an irgendwelchen Veranstaltungen während dieser Weltklimakonferenz teilzunehmen? Und wenn ja, wie beteiligt sich Taiwan daran?
We are going to you know, attend the conference, but because we are not an official member, so we can only participate in the NGO, non-government partners. And which is you know, in a way we are not treated fairly. We cannot sit with other government officials to formulate the many guidelines or convention rules, and so we can only learn. We can only send our scholars, researchers, academia professors, and also students to participate, but. 3 days ago, even our youth weather coalition members, all those students from various universities who helped themselves to come here, try to join with the international students to learn the impact or how to deal with this climate change issues. But our good friend, our good neighbors, Beijing government still interfere on this seminar, you know, all with all the students there. But fortunately, the host country, Korea, insists to continue the conference. And then, you know, the Chinese students just quit. They left that particular seminar. Too bad. Because climate change, global warming is really affects the health of the planet, the whole Earth. It will affect the happiness of next generation and our grandchildren. So the youth, this is your future. They ought to be included. But our students, even students, participate in that kind of NGO capacity are still intervened by the Beijing government. We are regret. We really regret for that. We hope they change their attitude.
Wie sieht denn Taiwans Beitrag zur Emissionsverringerung konkret aus?
I can describe that in two ways. First is to build, construct a very comprehensive legal framework. We enact the Greenhouse Gas Reduction and Management Act 2 years ago, and we are one of the very few countries that written our reduction targets into the law. We stipulate that we will cut the emission level by 50% of the 2005 level by 2050. And we will cut that's as a long-term target. For the intermediate target, we are going to cut 20% by 2030. And then the immediate goal is to cut 2% by 2025. It's from state by state, 2020, I should say. Cut 2% by 2020, 10% by 2025, 20% by 2030. Yeah, along the way. We are going to do all we can. Not only we are doing this, it's also a very clear policy stipulated directed by President Tsai Ing-wen in her inaugural speech last year.
Das heißt, obwohl China versucht haben, Taiwan aus all diesem gemeinsamen Kampf gegen diesen Klimawechsel und diese Emission von CO2 zu reduzieren, wir machen von uns aus, wir wollen aus freien Stücken, wir wollen das mitmachen. Und China hat versucht sozusagen, dass wir immer exkludiert werden. Trotzdem machen wir unter unserer Präsidentin Tsai Ing-wen, die hat gesagt, egal, wir machen das, weil das für Taiwan gut ist und weil das für die Welt gut ist.
Also, und das wollen wir noch mal ein bisschen konkretisieren. Welches Ziel hat denn Taiwan genau für die Treibhausgasemissionen und wie will es dieses erreichen? Und hat Taiwan neben diesem längerfristigen Ziel noch weitere festgelegt?
Oh, we are trying to restructure the energy mix. We would increase the renewable energy, that so-called green energy, from 5% to 20%. So in just one year, wind power, not only wind power, also solar power and all the water power. But wind power and the solar power are the basic component of all this green power. So including a German company, Danish company, British company, are investing billions of dollars in join our effort to increase the capacity of the wind power in central Taiwan and also the solar power. Yeah, so we are going all together. We are going to have 20% of green energy. So this will cut that kind of component at the emission level by 20%. Not only this, we also increase the natural gas power from some 20% to 50%, and then we'll cut down the coal energy, the coal because the main source of carbon dioxide, the coal from 45.5%, 4% to 30%. So we are in this transition period. In this way, by restructuring the energy mix, we will be able to cut down the emission level and then contribute to a reduction of the greenhouse gas in a major way.
Wir sehen große Beiträge in Taiwan, die müssen auch international natürlich bemerkt werden. Und das ist die nächste Frage nach einer kleinen Werbepause, die wir jetzt machen, an den Umweltminister von Taiwan, Dr. Li. Und dann wollen wir mal hören, was die internationale Gemeinschaft dafür leisten kann. Umgekehrt, was Taiwan für die internationale Gemeinschaft leisten kann. Bleiben Sie dran. Kurze Werbung, dann sind wir wieder da.